Thank you very much. Thank you. It has been a profound honor for us and a great joy to do these Kennedy Center honors for 8 years in a row now. This night and every night before it has been a profound honor for Hillary and me. You may find people who do this night better in the future. You will never find anybody who loves it as much. Thank you, and God bless you.
It has been called a glorious constellation of dance, music, theater, film, and television stars. Tonight, television's most honored program, the Kennedy Center Honors, a celebration of the performing arts.
Center Honors, honoring Mikhail Barishnikov, Chuck Berry, Placido Domingo, Clint Eastwood, Angela Lansbury. Ladies and gentlemen, Walter Cronkite.
Good evening and welcome to this 23rd Kennedy Center Honors. The spirit that surrounds this national celebration of the arts was expressed by a great American president half a century ago in the shadow of World War II. Franklin Delano Roosevelt said, "The arts cannot thrive except where men are free to be themselves and to be in charge of the discipline of their own energies and ardor." Behind me on our signature wall here are the names of those who have gone before. Tonight, we add the names of five artists to our roll of honor here. Consider their origins and the different paths they have taken to bring them here together tonight. A little kid who started in St. Louis with a four-string guitar and duck-walked his way into a rockin' place in musical history. A golden tenor born in Madrid who made the world his stage and gave opera a new word, superstar. A plucky gal from London who crossed the pond and found the highlands of film, theater, and television. An actor from Oakland, California, who decided that less was more and earned a fistful of success. A boy wonder from Riga, Latvia, whose bold leap to freedom led him to a new country and let him dance as no one else has, before or since.
Chuck, you had the most profound effect on my life. I have a little story to tell you. I grew up here in Washington, D.C., and my dad was a classical musician, and he played all the embassy parties, and he played the inaugurals from Roosevelt to Ford. And I remember looking over at him and saying, "Daddy, I will never like rock and roll. I'll always love classical music." And he'd look at me and he'd say, "That's my gal." And then I turned 13, and everything started happening. I started just becoming something I was unaware of, really. My body was just gyrating. So I'd go up to my room, and I would sneak off, and I would play Elvis, and I would play you, Chuck. That was a memory I will never forget. "Mr. Barry, your songs called out to a generation, and spread happiness all over the world. You are the poet laureate of rock and roll. Now, has anyone ever said it better? Roll over, Beethoven, and tell Tchaikovsky the news.
He was born with a knack for breaking the rules. When his mother Martha played, he liked to dance around the living room floor. When his father Henry took him along on weekend jobs, his eyes were wide open to the world. Sumner High, playing guitar was a hobby. Everyone knew he was a go-getter, but with no particular place to go. He tried factory work and hairdressing and wondered if anybody needed a cosmetician with a guitar. Then he joined a local blues group, turned up the heat, and soon they were calling it the Chuck Berry Trio. Next stop, Chicago, a hotbed for blues musicians. To the blues, Chuck added a shot of country and the thump of the boogie-woogie beat. He wrote a song about cars and young love, then announced himself with his guitar. His first song flew to the top of the black R&B charts. Then he started seeing a lot of blue eyes in the crowd. The 50s would never be the same. Just let me hear some of that rock and roll music. Any old way you choose it. Got a backbeat, you can't lose it. It was nothing less than a revolution, and he was the messenger of a new music and a new teenage culture. If you wanna
dance with me, sweet little 16, she's got the grown-up blues, tight dresses and lipstick, she's sporting high-heeled shoes. Oh, but tomorrow morning,
America's musical sun was transforming everyday life into pop masterpieces.
And back in class again.
His joyous sound served notice that a new day was dawning. John Lennon once said, if you gave rock and roll another name, it would be Chuck Berry. Each new wave of rockers points to him as a founding father, one of the first in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and still exploding 100 shows a year.
She moves around like a wayward summer breeze. Go, driver, go, go ahead, catch her for me, please. Moving through the traffic like a mounted cavalier. Leaning out the sexy women trying to make her hear. Nadine! Is that you? Wow! Nadine! Is that you? Every time I see you, honey, you up to something new. His mother told him someday you will be a man.
The storyteller of rock's golden age.
Many people coming from miles around.
He duck walked across the stage and into our history.
Someday your name will be in light saying, Johnny, be good tonight. Go, 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 Johnny, go.
When NASA launched Voyager into the galaxy bearing messages from Earth, it carried Bach, the U.S. Constitution, and you guessed it.
That's all, folks.
Next, an all-star rock and roll tribute to Chuck Berry on the Kennedy Center Honors.
Inspector Don Was has put together what tonight we call the Chuck Berry All-Stars. To take us down memory lane, they're joined by one of America's highest voltage rock and roll bands, the Black Crowes.
All right, Chuck. It's the wee hours. Some rock and roll music. We're talking about you. So let me tell you about a girl I know. Met her walking down an uptown street. She's so fine, you know, I wish she was mine. I get shook up every time we meet. I'm talking about you. Nobody but you. Yeah, to meet you. I'm just trying to get a message through.
Ladies and gentlemen, Little Richard.
I want to say something to Chuck. Everybody else got a chance to say something. Shut up! I love Chuck. I've traveled all over the country with him. He's one of the greatest entertainers I ever met, rock and roll. And don't nobody write like Chuck. He's the best writer I've ever heard of. He's a great, and a great entertainer, and a great father, great gentleman. And I just love Chuck. And this is to you, Chuck. Right, little lady, for a minute, coming over to Jay. It's a jumping record for my jockey to play. I'm going over Beethoven. You know the jukebox rocks, keep on playing the blues. I saw him go the Warner Brothers, down at the Rhythm Review. I'm rolling with Beethoven, driving in 2x2. Woo! Over Beethoven, roll over Beethoven. I'm rolling with Beethoven, I'm rolling with Beethoven.
Ladies and gentlemen, the B-52s.
You know, kick against my jazz, unless they try to play it too darn fast. And lose the beauty of the melody.
Sweet little 16, she just got to have about a half a million famed autograph. Her wallet filled with pictures, she gets them one by one. Become so excited, watch her look at her run. Oh, mommy, mommy, oh, please, oh, may I go? That's such a sight to see. Somebody steal the show. Daddy, baby, what's in a bag for you? I said I whispered to my man, but it's all right with you.
We got mad. I get shook up every time we meet. I'm talking about you. Nobody but you. Yeah, I do meet you. I'm just trying to get a message through.
Ladies and gentlemen, Little Richard.
I want to say something to Chuck. Everybody else got a chance to say something. Shut up! I love Chuck. I've traveled all over the country with him. He's one of the greatest entertainers I ever met, rock and roll. And don't nobody write like Chuck. He's the best writer I've ever heard of. He's a great, and a great entertainer, and a great father, great gentleman. And I just love Chuck. And this is to you, Chuck.
Ladies and gentlemen, the B-52s.
Get no kick against my jams.
Would be Chuck Berry. Each new wave of rockers points to him as a founding father. One of the first in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and still exploding 100 shows a year.
She moves around like a wayward summer breeze. Go, driver, go, go ahead and catch her for me, please. Move me through the traffic like a mounted cavalier. A leaning out the sexy women trying to make her hear. Nadine! Is that you? Wow! Nadine! Is that you? Every time I see you, honey, you up to something new. His mother told him someday you will be a man.
The storyteller of rock's golden age.
Many people coming from miles around.
He duck walked across the stage and into our history.
Your name will be in light saying, Johnny, be good tonight. Go, 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 Johnny, go.
When NASA launched Voyager into the galaxy bearing messages from Earth, it carried Bob, the U.S. Constitution, and you guessed it.
Next, an all-star rock and roll tribute to Chuck Berry on the Kennedy Center Honors.
Director Don Was has put together what tonight we call the Chuck Berry All-Stars. To take us down memory lane, They're joined by one of America's highest voltage rock and roll bands, the Black Crowes.
All right, Chuck. It's the wee wee hours. Some rock and roll music. We're talking about you. So let me tell you about a girl I know.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It has been a profound honor for us and a great joy to do these Kennedy Center honors for 8 years in a row now. This night and every night before it has been a profound honor for Hillary and me. You may find people who do this night better in the future. You will never find anybody who loves it as much. Thank you, and God bless you.
It has been called a glorious constellation of dance, music, theater, film, and television stars. Tonight, television's most honored program, the Kennedy Center Honors, a celebration of the performing arts.
Center Honors, honoring Mikhail Barishnikov, Chuck Berry, Placido Domingo, Clint Eastwood, Angela Lansbury. Ladies and gentlemen, Walter Cronkite.
Good evening and welcome to this 23rd Kennedy Center Honors. The spirit that surrounds this national celebration of the arts was expressed by a great American president half a century ago in the shadow of World War II. Franklin Delano Roosevelt said, "The arts cannot thrive except where men are free to be themselves and to be in charge of the discipline of their own energies and ardor." Behind me on our signature wall here are the names of those who have gone before. Tonight, we add the names of five artists to our roll of honor here. Consider their origins and the different paths they have taken to bring them here together tonight. A little kid who started in St. Louis with a four-string guitar and duck-walked his way into a rockin' place in musical history. A golden tenor born in Madrid who made the world his stage and gave opera a new word, superstar. A plucky gal from London who crossed the pond and found the highlands of film, theater, and television. An actor from Oakland, California, who decided that less was more and earned a fistful of success. A boy wonder from Riga, Latvia, whose bold leap to freedom led him to a new country and let him dance as no one else has, before or since.
Chuck, you had the most profound effect on my life. I have a little story to tell you. I grew up here in Washington, D.C., and my dad was a classical musician, and he played all the embassy parties, and he played the inaugurals from Roosevelt to Ford. And I remember looking over at him and saying, "Daddy, I will never like rock and roll. I'll always love classical music. And he'd look at me and he'd say, that's my gal. And then I turned 13. And everything started happening. I started just becoming something I was unaware of, really. My body was just gyrating. So I'd go up to my room and I would sneak off and I would play Elvis and I would play you, Chuck. That was a memory I will never forget. Mr. Barry, your songs called out to a generation and spread happiness all over the world. You are the poet laureate of rock and roll. Now, has anyone ever said it better? Roll over, Beethoven, and tell Tchaikovsky the news.
He was born with a knack for breaking the rules. When his mother Martha played, he liked to dance around the living room floor. When his father Henry took him along on weekend jobs, his eyes were wide open to the world. At Sumner High, playing guitar was a hobby. Everyone knew he was a go-getter, but with no particular place to go. He tried factory work and hairdressing, and wondered if anybody needed a cosmetician with a guitar. Then he joined a local blues group, turned up the heat, and soon they were calling it the Chuck Berry Trio. Next stop, Chicago, a hotbed for blues musicians. To the blues, Chuck added a shot of country and the thump of the boogie-woogie beat. He wrote a song about cars and young love, then announced himself with his guitar.
Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true?
His first song flew to the top of the black R&B charts. Then he started seeing a lot of blue eyes in the crowd. The 50s would never be the same.
Just let me hear some of that rock and roll music. Any old way you choose it. Got a backbeat, you can't lose it.
It was nothing less than a revolution. And he was the messenger of a new music and a new teenage culture.
If you want to dance with me. Sweet little 16. She's got the grown-up blues. Tight dresses and lipstick. She's sporting high-heel shoes. Oh, but tomorrow morning...
America's musical sun was transforming everyday life into pop masterpieces.
And back in class again.
His joyous sound served notice that a new day was dawning. John Lennon once said, if you gave rock and roll another name,